Hello, welcome to Lovely Lovebird Designs. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a corgi on the rainbow loom. He has a long body, and most corgis are docked, so if you don't want a tail, you don't have to add the tail, and just use a regular capping band for the end. I used the camo pack from Rainbow Loom, and this is the lighter shade of beige in the camo pack, and I have pointy ears and a nice white snout, and I think he came out really cute. So also in this one I made a little brown on the front. In the tutorial I'm going to make this chest area all white. So you'll need two different colors if you want to make it this kind, and corgis come in different colors, so whatever color you choose you can use them. But in this tutorial I'm going to use the light tan color and white. Okay, let's get started. You will need a single loom and arrow facing down, staggered position. So we're going to start with the fur color, the primary fur color right now, and the light tan. And we're going to place it from the top pin facing down. Okay, and I also added some more bands. I have other dog tutorials, and I made this forehead a little bit more fuller, so it's a little bit different head than the other dogs that I've had. So this band going this way, and then top to the left, and then this is where I put the fuller head, and they're all double bands too. Okay, we're going to place on the diagonal right here, and then we're going to do another diagonal right here. Okay, and then we're going to go to white for in between the eyes. So a double white. And then I'm going to do another double white for the snout area. And then the side of the head will be the tan. And then one big stretch to the bottom pin. So this pin to here is a big stretch. And then we're placing it on the left side of the head. And when we're all done with the dog, there's a lot of band changes that I maneuver the bands on the head to make it this shape. So it doesn't really look like a corgi when it comes off the loom, but I move everything around so it's the shape of the dog's head. It's an extra special dog. So another big stretch down. Okay, now we're going to get into the white chest area, and it's going to be a triple band of white. So three. Okay, and then as I said before, I want white bands right here instead of tan. So I'm going to put white right here on the sides. But first I'm going to put tan in the middle. There's one tan in the middle. These are double now. This is a triple. This is double. Double, and they're double from now on. So this will make the tan chest. Then we're going to do tan going down. So double up tan. Okay, so we're going to do four stitches down with the tan. So here's one, two, three, and number four. Okay, then we're gonna go in the middle. Well, let's do the left side. Same as the right, going all the way down. Okay, one more. Now we'll do the middle bands, and I'm doing the same tan. Okay, and one more. So now we're going to do connecting bands right here. Okay, we can make the tail now. Now, some of the corgis are not, do not have tails and they're docked. But if you want a docked corgi, I would just do a double band and wrap it around this two times. Now, if you want a tail on yours, I have three stitches right here. It's a little tail, and I'll show you how to do the tail right now. It is a single wrapped three times around the hook, then a double, place it on your hook, place that little capping band on the middle, place it back on the hook so it looks like this. Take another double, place it like that, and another double. Pretty easy. Okay, then you're going to place it right here for your capping band. Okay, now I'm going to make the legs. In the front, I have white on the bottom and then a triple of the tan. So we'll do that. Single white wrapped three times. So one, two, three. Then a double white on the hook. Place it in the middle. Bring it back on there. Then I'm going to take a triple of the tan. I do triple because they're stocky dogs. They're very furry. So we're going to do a triple. Place that on the hook. And we're going to place it right here. Okay, just like that. Now we're going to repeat over here. Single. One, two, three. Take a double. Place it back on the hook. Then take a triple of the tan. And then we're going to place it right here. Okay, just like that. Now the legs are a little bit different. Same on the bottom, but we're doing the legs like we're going to put thighs, so it's connecting to two bands, two pins. So, single. One, two, three. Another double. Place it on there so it looks like that. Then you're going to take your triple of the tan. Place the white on there. Keep it like this. And you're going to connect, put it on this pin and one on here. And that is your thigh and back hind legs. Repeat on the right side. One, two, three. Triple, no, a double, sorry. Then a triple. Just like that, and we're going to place it on this bottom pin and that one, so these two pins. Okay, so we'll put some structural bands on the body and then we'll work on the head. So these are single, and it's the color of your body. Single and triangle. Another triangle here. Another triangle there. And one last one here. So now let's work on the head, and we'll do the snout first. So we're going to do a black nose, put it on the hook. You can wrap it around four times, 1, 2, 3, and 4. You can do it that way, or you can place it on the hook, wrap it around once, like a figure eight, then grab that and wrap it around again. So that's four also. So now the snout is three bands of white. Okay, so you take your triple band, place the black right in the middle, back on the hook. Then I want the color of the outside coat, which is the tan, and I'm going to take a single, place that on the single, and I'm going to connect these two pins. I'm going to bring it under this middle pin, bring it back on that one. So snout is right here. Okay, now the eyes, the same as before. You can wrap it around four times or even use beads. I'm going to do the twice around and another. Take another twice, go around that, figure eight. Grab it and then another. Same tan. Bring the eye. Then I'm going to connect these two pins. So here's one. Bring it underneath this pin. And two. Okay, we're almost done. Then we're going to make the ears. And if you made my chihuahua, it's the same type of ear, but the banding is different on the head. So I'm going to take, need a total of four bands. So one, put it on the hook, wrap four times. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Take another. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you take a double, so two bands. Place those on the bands to the side and to the side. You want a space in the middle. Then place it back on your hook. And when we're maneuvering the bands, I'll show you how to make it pointy. We're going to place it right here. So push this down a little bit so you have space. Okay, and that is one ear. Okay, we're going to make another ear. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then another one, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Take your double. Place it on the hook. Okay, place that back on the hook. And we're going to place it right here. Okay, so this is your layout. Make sure it looks like mine. Make sure yours looks like this one. And we can start looming. So we'll pull back the tail. If you have a dock tail, you just go underneath the capping band. And this is my top band, so I'm going to grab this one first. Put it to this pin, then I'm going to go grab that one. Put it to the right, and finally the middle. I'm going to loom the middle first. And just loom up. Okay, then we're going to loom the right side, and we're not touching any of these bands. We're just touching the bottom bands, okay? So we're just grabbing this bottom band all the way down underneath and just loom forward. Okay, now we're going to grab this white band. Okay, same here. We're not touching these. We're just going under and get that double white. I mean, the double at the bottom of tan. Okay, now we're grabbing this white. Okay, now we're grabbing this triple white on the bottom. Okay, so this maneuvering, this looping of the bands on here are a little bit different. So we're going to do the bottom of the head first, and then we're going to stop here and then work on these. So we're going to grab this one. Bring that nose up, then grab the next tan. And then we're going to grab the white, and we're going to make the nose, the snout, go through the white. So pull it through. Okay, so that's that. Then we're going to grab this white and loom to the middle. Okay, so now we stopped right here. We didn't loom this yet. We're going to grab this band right here. Pay it close attention. It's the uppermost band. We're going to go underneath this band, grab this one right here, and bring it to this ear. So go underneath the little eye band. Grab, I got it, the uppermost band, and it goes to the left ear. Keep the eyes down. Now we're grabbing this one. Okay, that's the next band in our sequence. Right there. Keep the eyes down. Now finally, this middle band. And you see that. So you can see this band going to the left, this one in the middle, this one here. There's no knots or anything in this area. Now we're going to loom this right side. Hard part is over. Now I'm just grabbing this bottom band. There's a lot of bands here. Just the bottom. And bring it there. Can loosen that up. Okay, same on the left side. And just the bottom. Loosen that up. Okay, this is banded. So make sure yours looks like mine. We're going to do a double of the tan color for the top. for a slip knot. So put your hook right through, grab the double, move it right on the tippy top. Now I like to take the hook off and make sure the bands are straight and not twisted. Place it back and then make your little slip knot. And then we can take it off the loom. Okay, so we're going to take it slowly off the loom. And remember, when you take it off the loom, it's not going to look exactly like the dog. We have to sew the body shut to make it round and 3D. And we also have to maneuver the bands on the top of the head, so it's more dog shape. Okay, it's very thick bands by the ears. And finally the nose. Okay, you don't need the loom anymore. Okay, so this is where we're going to maneuver stuff. Pull the ears, put your finger behind the head and push it so the eyes come out. Pull the eyes for both of them. Pull the snout. Make sure the nose is in the middle. Okay, his ears we're going to fix later, and this so it doesn't look like this. We're going to work on the body first. We're going to make this look like this by moving some bands around. But we're going to work on the body and sew the body first. So pull everything out, legs out, tail down. Okay, first you have that triple band neck. Put your hook underneath the neck, the triple, pull the bands, and then now it's standing up, and we're going to sew the body shut. We need a single tan band. There's these two bands right here. You can see them. Put your hook underneath that little shoulder area. Take your band, place it on the hook, bring it under. Then you're going to place the end of it like that, back on the hook, and make a little slip knot so you can pull that right side over so it's a knot. Then we're going to go to the next row. Put your hook underneath, so it looks like that. Grab that band and pull it under. Bring it taut. Then we're going to go to the next stitch. Okay, it's right here and right here. Okay, then put the band under, pull it. We're just sewing it shut. Then here's your next stitch right underneath that. Put your hook, sew it shut, and finally one more. The little hind leg area. And pull it through. So now you can either put a C-clip on this and hide it within the body, or what I like to do is you can cut this and then make a knot. So here's the end of the band. I'm going to cut the band. Then I'm going to take any of these little belly bands, take one side, tuck it underneath here, Okay. So it's underneath one, and then I'm going to pull it up, and then it's secure. Then I'm just going to tie a knot. Tie a double knot. Okay, one. And two. Okay, and make sure to cut the excess. Don't cut yourself, and do not cut the rest of the body. And then it can just go in there, pull the body out, pull the tail, I mean the legs down. To make the tail, if you want the tail down, you can keep it down like that, or you can just grab the second stitch, here's one, two, and pull again so that the tail goes up. So now the tail goes up. Pull this so it's more straight. And now we're going to work with the face. Okay, so there is this band right here. There's two bands. And there's two bands right here. We're going to take those two bands, pull it behind the ear. Okay? Once again, here's two bands right here. We're going to take it, pull it behind the ear. Okay? So now, we're going to pull this out, and you're going to see it's attached, the ear is attached to this band. We're going to hold the bottom of the band and pull it up the ear, because we want the ear straight up. So we're just pulling that up. So now the ear is more up. Pull this ear out, hold that bottom band, put it up to the tippy top of his head. So now you can see what we did. We took off some from the side of the head and we made the ears up. Now we have a wrapped band here on the left side and a wrapped band on the right side. So we're going to maneuver the bands so there's a space here. So I'm going to put the wrap bands down on the right side, wrapped down on the left side. Then I'm going to grab one little part of the band, bring it to the middle so it's pointy. Take another part and bring that to the middle on the other side. So now that's pointy. Same over here. One wrap band to the right, one wrap band to the left, then we're going to take one band and bring it in the middle, and one band and bring it in the middle, so they're pointy. Okay, so now you can see it's more pointy on the top. I'm going to hide this excess band through the top of this head. I can see a little bit of the white on the top. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my hook, go underneath this bunch of bands, find, go underneath in the middle. Sorry, I'm underneath. I went through the back of the head. Went in the middle right here of this white band right here. Then I'm going to grab this excess band, put it on my hook just like that, then pull it through. And now I'm not seeing that white band right there, and it's more straight here. Okay, there's one more thing. If you like your corgi like this, you can keep him like that. But I just moved two more little bands on the head, just because I'm a little bit picky with the dog breeds. I want them to be as close as I can. There's a little bit more fuller on the side of the head on this one than this one. And if you like your corgi like this, you can keep it like that. But if you want a little bit fuller underneath the ear, there is this band right here. You can see it. There's two little bands right here. You can grab those two little bands, pull your ear through them, and then it makes the side of the head a little bit more fuller. Now I'm going to grab the two little bands over here and pull the ear through. And it makes just the side of the head a little bit more fuller. And pull the ears out, grab the bottom of the ear again and move it more up on top of the head. Pull the bottom, make it more up on top of the head. And you can maneuver the bands. And you have a cute little corgi. Just move them around a little bit. Make sure they're even. And I really, really worked on this design. I really hope you like it. Just maneuvering the bands a little bit will make the shape of the head a lot more clear and corgi-like. And the ears on top. And you can pull them down if they moved a little bit. Pull them down and do the bands in the middle again to make them pointy. And here's your corgi. It's 3D. I really hope you like this tutorial. And please subscribe. Okay, bye. And then I'm going to do another double white for the snout area. And then the side of the head will be the tan. And then one big stretch to the bottom pin. So this pin to here is a big stretch. And then we're placing it on the left side of the head. And when we're all done with the dog, there's a lot of band changes that I maneuver the bands on the head to make it this shape. So it doesn't really look like a corgi when it comes off the loom, but I move everything around so it's the shape of the dog's head. It's an extra special dog. So another big stretch down. Okay, now we're going to get into the white chest area, and it's going to be a triple band of white, so three. Okay, and then, as I said before, I want white bands right here instead of tan. So I'm going to put white right here on the sides. But first I'm going to put tan in the middle. There's one tan in the middle. These are double now. This is a triple. This is double. Double. And they're double from now on. So this will make the tan chest. Then we're going to do tan going down. So double up tan. Okay, so we're going to do four stitches down with the tan. So here's one, two, three, and number four. Okay, then we're gonna go in the middle. Well, let's do the left side. Same as the right, going all the way down. Okay, one more. Now we'll do the middle bands, and I'm doing the same tan. Okay, and one more. So now we're going to do connecting bands right here. Okay, we can make the tail now. Now, some of the corgis are not do not have tails and they're docked. But if you want a docked corgi, I would just do a double band and wrap it around this two times. Now, if you want a tail on yours, I have three stitches right here. It's a little tail, and I'll show you how to do the tail right now. It is a single wrapped three times around the hook, then a double, place it on your hook, place that little capping band on the middle, place it back on the hook so it looks like this, take another double, place it like that, and another double. Pretty easy. Okay, then you're going to place it right here for your capping band. Okay, now I'm going to make the legs. In the front, I have white on the bottom and then a triple of the tan. So we'll do that. Single white wrapped three times. So one, two, three. Hello, welcome to Lovely Lovebird Designs. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a corgi on the rainbow loom. He has a long body, and most corgis are docked, so if you don't want a tail, you don't have to add the tail, and just use a regular capping band for the end. I used the camo pack from Rainbow Loom, and this is the lighter shade of beige in the camo pack, and I have pointy ears and a nice white snout, and I think he came out really cute. So also in this tutorial, in this one, I made a little brown on the front. In the tutorial, I'm gonna make this chest area all white. So you'll need two different colors if you wanna make it this kind, and corgis come in different colors, so whatever color you choose, you can use them. But in this tutorial, I'm gonna use the light tan color and white. Okay, let's get started. You will need a single loom and arrow facing down, staggered position. So we're going to start with the fur color, the primary fur color right now, and the light tan. And we're going to place it from the top pin facing down. And I also added some more bands. I have other dog tutorials, and I made this forehead a little bit more fuller, so it's a little bit different head than the other dogs that I've had. So this band going this way, and then top to the left, and then this is where I put the fuller head, and they're all double bands too. Okay, we're going to place on the diagonal right here, and then we're going to do another diagonal right here. Okay, and then we're going to go to white for in between the eyes. So a double white. Then a triple. Okay, just like that. And we're going to place it on this bottom pin. And that one. So these two pins. Okay, so we'll put some structural bands on the body and then we'll work on the head. So these are single. And it's the color of your body, single and triangle, another triangle here, another triangle there, and one last one here. So now let's work on the head, and we'll do the snout first. So we're going to do a black nose, put it on the hook. You can wrap it around four times, one, two, three, and four. You can do it that way, or you can place it on the hook, wrap it around once, like a figure eight, then grab that and wrap it around again. So that's four also. So now the snout is three bands of white. Okay, so you take your triple band, place the black right in the middle, back on the hook. Then I want the color of the outside coat, which is the tan, and I'm going to take a single, place that on the single, and I'm going to connect these two pins. I'm going to bring it under this middle pin, bring it back on that one. So snout is right here. Okay, now the eyes, the same as before, you can wrap it. Then a double white on the hook, place it in the middle, bring it back on there. Then I'm going to take a triple of the tan. I do triple because they're stocky dogs. They're very furry. So we're going to do a triple. Place that on the hook, and we're going to place it right here. Okay, just like that. Now we're going to repeat over here. Single, one, two, three. Take a double. Place it back on the hook. Then take a triple of the tan. And then we're going to place it right here. Okay, just like that. Now the legs are a little bit different. Same on the bottom, but we're doing the legs like we're going to put thighs, so it's connecting to two bands, two pins. So, single, one, two, three, another double, place it on there so it looks like that. Then you're going to take your triple of the tan. Place the white on there, keep it like this, and you're going to connect, put it on this pin, and one on here. And that is your thigh and back hind legs. Repeat on the right side, one, two, three, triple, no, a double, sorry.